Hi, and welcome to this, the ninth video in the SPT Framework series. Today we're going to pick up where we left off after the command video, and we're going to extend our components to introduce the concept of tracing. Now in the command video, I showed you how to trigger behaviors inside the component and report that back to higher level software using the busy and error flags and an error ID, should you wish to. In this video, we're looking at what you can do when you're developing your program on for your machine to report back from the program what's actually going on inside it into the development environment. So that's what tracing is. It's a tool that you can use when you're debugging or when you're developing to report things back out to the IDE, so to Visual Studio, to TwinCat itself, and tell you what's going on. So we could, for example, use it on an Axis class to report a move that was commanded, the acceleration, deceleration properties that was given at that time. In our case, we're going to have the messages come out from the response to our reset command. So when we reset the counter and it passes, we'll send that to the IDE, and when we fail, we'll set that to the IDE, and you'll be able to see that happen here. Okay, so picking up where we left off at the end of the last one, you remember that we had our flow control error being reported into our main program, into our flow control error flag, so that if the system went into error, we could then see that in the program. But that's what's happening programmatically. So if you want to see that, you have to go through and find that in your program. So if your HMI isn't set up ready to report that error, then you can't see it. And you'll have to go through your program code to go find that error and then and read it. But it'd be much nicer if we could have a method by which we could report that out to the IDE itself. And that's entirely possible here. So under a reset worked or reset fail condition, we actually want to write something out to the development environment itself to tell us that something's happened. And the trace, the method here, is how you do that. So all you need to do to implement this system is simply type trace, open the brackets, and you can see it then takes a message, which is just a string. So in your case, so all you need to do is write in the string. For this particular example, it's going to be that we called the reset and it passed. And when we look at the fail message, we can do the same thing. So we call trace, open brackets, and then start a string, and we can say call the reset and it failed. Quite simple. Okay, so we close the bracket off and finish off a semicolon, and now that's it. That's all you have to do. Okay, so really quite simple, straightforward way of doing it. This all comes from the SPT framework, so it's actually already built into it. So if we go look at the source of the trace, it's actually coming from a global variable list that lives inside the SPT framework. So you'll find a set of parameters inside the SPT framework, which you can see here. And we can do a global setting to enable disable. We can have a number of log messages per scan, so we can limit it. And we can also allow for duplicate messages if we want to keep pulsing the same thing. Okay, but we'll come back to those settings in a bit later in the video. For right now, you can see under the tracing folder of the SPT library, there's a global variable list. Very simple, and it just has a reference to an instance of this function block, the function block trace log, and that just sits there in the library, and then you can use it. And it's kind of like static types in other languages. Okay, so the global variable list lives inside the library, which means you can just call trace inside your component, and you have access to it from anywhere. Okay, so we've implemented that inside our component. So now when we run the reset counter, we'll trigger this behavior inside the cyclic logic. When we then give it a reset worked or failed, we should hopefully see this being reported out into the development environment window. So let's log in, go to our main program here, still triggering the exact same code as previously. We'll just offer these things up side by side so you can actually see what's actually going on together. Trigger our event to reset the counter, and you can see now that's started. Nothing's happened in the output window so far because it's waiting now for that reset succeeded. So we hit that, and you'll notice there was an extra message popped up. We just scroll down to it here, and you can see that there with the message that I print out that a reset was commanded and it passed. Very simple. Do the same thing again with a failed, and you can see the number of messages incremented again by one. And here we have the reset started and it failed, all in our output window. So you can imagine extending that now to all your other systems and having a fully logged or traced system. So every time that a command gets made or an action happens, we can trace that out and bring that out to the IDE, and you can then see that being reported out in the system, and then you can go back as almost like a memory file, essentially, of everything that's happened inside the system. We can extend that further, that logic, and actually go into the reset counter method and add it to the actual command itself. So we'll get basically two messages now whenever we do this functionality. So you can see here we're going to do trace, and then the message is going to be the reset function has been called. So when we trigger this from main, we'll get a message saying reset function called, and then when we complete the method, or complete the execution, I should say, you'll then see the messages come back saying passed or failed. So here we trigger the initial one. Let me just clear the window so we can see this a bit more clearly. There you can see the reset has been called, and now if we complete the process, it's passed. Do it again, we get the reset called, and now we'll fail, and there you have it. Okay, and a really simple system so that you can log what's going on in your system. So this would be useful for debugging and just for simply understanding what's going on all at the same time on the PLC cycles of your code. So you may say that's great, but how do I prevent loads of build up in my IDE and clutter? And if we go back to the SPT base types library, that tracing parameter list that we saw, if we set the tracing name to false, what that does is it disables that function block inside that global variable list in the library and stops tracing being recorded. So if I clear the output window here and call the command, you can see nothing happened. If I go back into the system and go to the actual cyclic logic of the system and trigger the complete flag, for example, for the cycle, you can also see that's not reported. Okay. If I log back out, set the tracing enabled back to true, and then log back into my system now, you'll see that when I run the code again, or trigger the cycle again, I now get those messages appearing in my output window once more. So you see, you can turn it on and off when you don't need it. So this is a useful thing for the development stages of your cycle, or you can leave it in so that should a customer have an issue with a machine, you can turn the tracing on and log all the things that are going on inside that machine, and then, excuse me, and then have a record of what's happened before you hit a problem. Okay, so you can go back and debug where the machine was, what states it was in, etc., etc. The tracing is a complicated topic. It's entirely up to you how far you go with it. Yeah, so some people log literally everything right down to motion commands. Some people log general structures, state machine progression, that sort of stuff. It's entirely up to you, but this is the tool in with which you would do that. So in the next video, we're going to take this on and push out some JSON strings as well with our tracing so that you can include extra data with your messages being passed out to the global log and give you a bit more depth and volume to that information that's been passed out. Thanks for listening. See you next time.